Hi, in this video I will be going through a template I built a long time ago that analyzes variances by calculating a total overall variance, and then the template examines the total variance for how price, volume, and mix affect that overall variance. Many sources can teach you how to calculate price and volume variances, but few give you help on how to do a mix variance. So in part one here, in the first part of this template, the calculation gives us the overall variance in comparing these two monthly snapshots of my utility bill. In 2015, I used 470 units of electricity and paid a total cost for that of $52.46. In 2016, I used 590 units of electricity and paid a total cost of $65.36. And you can see I've also placed in this template my usage for natural gas. The template comes up with an average cost by dividing the units into the total cost. The same calculation is done for the natural gas. Then the total variance is calculated by showing the difference in units and the difference in costs. Thus, when you compare October 2015 to October 2016, the total spending variance is $10.95. This is an unfavorable variance because I did spend more in 2016 than in 2015. Now, in the next calculation, I'm looking at how price affects that overall variance. The calculation uses the volume from 2016, and it is looking at the unit price difference between 2015 to 2016. In this calculation, you can see that the price impact is a positive one. From 2015 to 2016, the actual unit price fell for both electricity and natural gas. In the next calculation, the template is examining how the mixture of products purchased has affected the total variance. What this does is it takes the 2015 total units and recalculates the mix of products based on the mix in 2016. As you can see here, natural gas is driving a very positive variance. And finally, this final calculation looks at the effect of the volume on the total variance. In 2016, there was a much higher volume usage, and that higher volume drives a large volume variance. Thus, what we have here is an interesting situation. If we only looked at the total variance, we might not get the best picture of what has happened here. Once we calculate the individual contributing variances of price, volume, and mix, we see there are big swings in these factors. This helps us to have a very good idea of what we can control and what we cannot control within these variances. I hope this template is useful to you. You can look at this with any data that has units and dollars associated with it. You can compare sales or expenses. It just depends on what you need to do with the template. Also, I have a second template for download that has more granularity for costs, meaning that if you have something that has freight costs or other charges, you can break out those prices as well. In addition, you can add lines so that you can analyze more than two or three products. Enjoy the template. With this one tool, you can impress people with your financial intelligence.